Come on. Let's go.
I'm trying to sunbathe. I want a tan. I'm not black enough. I'm not black enough. Just come back and get me. I'm gonna just scroll around. Yeah.
Come on, let's go.
Well, maybe I'm first.
Come on. Aw, hell. Damn. Y'all, all I did was walk past the window. Oh. Damn. Okay. RV outside and our new neighbors, they getting their household goods today. Yeah, my ass about to get ghost because I'm not about to be stranded because they be trying to block folks. Do you feel me? So, y'all, I got 30 minutes to get dressed right quick because I got to go run out to Jay to school and pay her lunch. Y'all, my daughter do this to me like every couple of weeks. Jada don't bring home the slip. The school just started allowing you to pay online. That's how like far behind her school is. Yeah. However, thank God we won't have this issue in high school. But I gotta go run out to the school now because they called James and talking about Jada won't get her diploma if her lunch ain't paid. Really? Is it that serious? Stop giving Jada notes and just contact us like you contacted him this morning. And we won't be having these damn problems. You feel me? Now let me get dressed. All right, y'all. Done went out to Jada's school and taking care of her lunch fees. And y'all just did the calculations. Go ahead and pay for the rest of the damn year. Because, Lord, have mercy. They don't get out of school here up north until like the 20th or 21st. And crazy. They have a program where, you know, minors can start working when they turn 15, 16 years old. Jada need a job, y'all. She need a damn job. She really needs to learn the value of money. And we had this conversation the other day when we were out shopping. And, y'all, when children learn that, okay, I worked 10 hours, and for 10 hours, I made $80, and who the hell is FICA taking some of my $80, okay? So now, them $80 that you thought you earned and I turned into like maybe $70, okay? Because you know they don't take that much tax with little kids. But at the same token, you start like really recognizing if you need them J's or not, or if you need them new Pumas. Jada is like slightly a sneakerhead, and like she always wanting stuff. And y'all, I do not believe in spoiling your children. I just don't. I believe in you need to learn how to earn it. And once you earn it, just because your ass bought it, that don't mean you're gonna keep it. Because I still will take your phone away from you, okay? So there is a program during the summer where the kids can work, and it actually starts immediately right after school. So it's actually making me reassess if she's gonna go to my mom's house or not, because if Jada gets accepted in the program, child, one thing about Jada is all about making some money, okay? She is about the grind and the hustle. And if that's a way that she can guarantee that she can get her nails done and, you know, new J's come out, she can go stand out there in the line and get them because she gonna pay for them. Jada's about her hustle. So I'm gonna talk to her dad about it. I already know where his mindset would be, because clearly y'all see where mine at, right? And I think it'll just be a great opportunity for her to learn early on about the working community, the working family, the working teenager. How about that? So, it would be great for her to go and spend time with grandma. However, it also would be great if she could stay here and get her a summer job and make her some bread, okay? Because I think they hire Yeah, they do. They hire kids her age at the commissary on base, and Jada could be a bad girl. Or somebody that like helps with produce and stuff like that. You feel me? Yep. All hands agree for children making money, learning the dollar bill, learning the value of the dollar bill. Me. Yep. So if y'all wondering where I'm headed now, I'm actually headed to the Lexus dealership because I was gonna go get my car washed because y'all, this pollen got black looking green, okay? And ooh, it's like uncoated my glasses too. So honey, Lexus, the beautiful thing about having a luxury vehicle is taking your car to the dealership. And yep, you gonna pay about $69 for an oil change. However, that oil change comes with a car wash, oil change, lunch, cause yes, they be having like chicken wraps and turkey sandwiches and all that stuff up in there, and free Wi-Fi. So yep, I can sit there while they service my car and get my car washed. And yeah, today I need to get some new windshield wipers, and my light just came on. Oil maintenance required. See, you gotta know your boo. Lexi, I know her. Yeah, and really, I was reminded by the little messenger on the dashboard. Yep, you need an oil change. And my light just came on, so that's where I'm headed. I am headed to the Lexus dealership. And y'all, I was cracking up earlier on Facebook because, you know, everybody tripping about the gorilla getting shot, okay? Everybody tripping about that. And this is my little two cents. Animal activists are like going off and, oh, they could have tranquilized the gorilla, or they didn't have to kill it, or really? I'm like, y'all know I have a pet, so you know I love the animals, okay? However, if it's gonna be Rocky about to like kill a child or do something like that remotely can like, he's gonna get put to sleep anyway. Yeah, guess what? You gotta do what you gotta do. A child's life, a human's life is important. And I'm sorry, but the gorilla could have really messed that kid up. And I mean, they already said that, and I saw video footage where, you know, the gorilla was like dragging the little boy like violently, okay? So they had to tranquilize that gorilla. That gorilla just could have went ape, like for real, okay? People was like really pissed off about it, but them type of animals, monkeys, apes, gorillas, orangutans, they are very intelligent, and they already said he was a bit disoriented as it was. So even the zoo people said if they had to make the same decision again, they would do the same thing they did. Now, all I could think about when I was like reading this, y'all, I could just think about my little nephews like Rome and Omari. I could just think about how, you know, they so quick on their feet because they're so little and they so fast and they be all into shit. I could just see Rome being that little kid because he is like, y'all, he mischievous like that, like for real. Omari is too, but I don't know if Omari would have been that curious. I could see Ron being very curious about, ooh, let me go see the monkey. Let me touch him. Let me see if he's real. Because Ron ain't scared of Rocky. And Rocky can be smiling, showing teeth and all, y'all, and he ain't scared, okay? So I was just like, yes, I would have wanted them to do what they had to do with that gorilla in order to save my nephew. Sorry. It is what it is. And I love animals, but I love the kids, okay? So y'all, let me get up here. Don't y'all be trying to come for me if I have any animal activists on here. Don't be trying to come for me because they had to do what they had to do, and they had to act fast. They had to act fast. Let me continue driving, y'all. Bye. Your game is on, give me a
call me if your love is strong. Gotta give my all to you every day. I'll be calling my name. I need you. I want you to have you, hold you, squeeze you. Y'all, look who I done ran into. Look at my lunch.
Roger, I thought I changed that. I didn't do it.
Oh. Sushi time. Can't even complain about no heat. We've been waiting on the heat. Deal with it.
All right, y'all. I'm leaving Walgreens because I just wanted, I was looking for this powder and I found it at Walgreens versus Target. And I've been to Target, I've been to where else have I been? Target, Home Goods, Marshalls, and this is the powder that I was looking for. Jeffree Star sets a lot of his highlight and his makeup with this. So I'm going to try it. And when I asked the lady in the store, y'all, like, did they have it? She told me some, oh, this old school. She was like, my mama used this. And she was quite mature. That's what I'm going to say. She was quite mature. So she was like, I see people are like still buying this. Well, sometimes the old school-ish works better than this new school-ish. Do y'all feel me? So y'all, let me get my ass home so I can get to the gym and go work out. And whoo, y'all, tell y'all, when this heat came, it came with a vengeance. Like, no pre-warning, no nothing, no pre-game or nothing, okay, period. So let me get my butt to the house. So I got my car serviced and had lunch with Mr. Long. And now it's time to get home. Woo! On record and say this. I don't see how chicks wear waist cinchers all day. Oh, let me just say this. I just felt like my ass could not breathe. I had to take that shit off. Reason why I gotta keep doing what I'm doing and working out, because honey, that shit right there is for the birds. For I don't like shake well. I don't. Ain't nothing sexy about it. Trying to get with your man and then you gotta take that shit off. Bullshit. Can have that ish. I'll stick to continuing to work out to get snatched. I know you got a car dance.
Hello.
And is that my jacket you got on?
Yeah, I grabbed it.
You always grabbing shit that don't belong to you. Not funny. Not even a little bit. Do I look like I'm smiling? Yes, y'all, and it's about dark outside, and yep, I'm still rocking them shades. Cause I can see. Hi, we will take a, that was a whole,
yep.
We'll take a half steak and cheese with everything on it. You want half? Let me see it. We might need a whole. Yeah, a whole. Everything on it. I paid it. Did y'all hear that? Did y'all hear that? Didn't I talk about lunch earlier?
Oh, she made it seem like we should call you later. Like, she made it seem like I never asked you guys about it. I can just hear Dad.
She told me about going to 20.
Because I told Mommy about it.
Ham and cheese?
Excuse me?
Ham and cheese?
No. Cheesesteak.
Oh, cheesesteak.
Yes. Everything on it, onions, grilled onions, peppers, banana, lettuce, mayonnaise, banana peppers, tomatoes, and salt and pepper. No oil and vinegar. Sandwich be soggy by the time you get home.
Get your hand out your mouth. It's so nasty. It's my favorite.
It's germs. You wonder why you sick, that's why. You keep putting germs in your body.
It's because I have bad allergies.
So Jada, do you have a date to this dance?
No.
Why?
I don't know.
What did your daddy say to you?
He go with his people, I go with mine. I don't have a date. Apparently nobody asked me.
No, because you was trying to have a little charity case. I told y'all, don't be no charity date for nobody.
What are you talking about?
You told me he lost his brother, so you felt bad. And you was like, I'm going to be his date.
I'm not the type of person that turned out he's a special kid, Mom. Like, you guys have no heart.
Ain't about having a heart. It's about not having pity.
What?
Pity. It's like you're taking doing a pity date. That's what it's like. Oh, I feel bad, so I'm just gonna go with him. Why did I do that shit at? Chabu. Let me get our sandwich. We'll talk to y'all later. Okay, okay.
Nothing healthy about this, but it's about to be good to me.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody needs a break.
Every day, when these men used to be talking about it was their right to rape you. What? Get the hell out of Dodge. And the wife stand there. Say good morning.
Oh, good morning, y'all. I got a pee.
Good morning, y'all. I'm in a rush. I'm trying to get to the gym this morning for booty duty start. Because I want to do this new cardio hit. So let me put my earrings on and get my sneakers on, and I'll be right back.
Told y'all I'll be back.
Y'all probably was like, Steph, I didn't know you were still working out. I didn't know if y'all was bored with seeing me work out all the damn time. So that's why y'all ain't been seeing all of that. But still working out. And now that the sun wants to beam and be graciously hot, yeah, y'all, I would love to go to the track, but Stephanie don't want an uneven suntan. Yeah, I don't want an uneven suntan, so I'm going to pass. But hopefully this weekend the weather is nice on Saturday, and I'm gonna go to the pool, and I'm gonna sit out by the pool, and I am going to get me a tan, y'all. Legs and all. Yep. Legs, arms, shoulders, knees, and hands. Hello. So about to get in this gym, because y'all, I gotta get there before booty duty. Y'all already know that, okay? And get my extreme finitis on. So I'll holler back at y'all at the gym. Y'all, booty duty look like it started early today, okay? It don't look like I beat shit. But this is what I got on, y'all. Miami Heat gear. All the way. Going to the back, because all them sailors is out there doing organized PT in the middle of the gym. Mm-hmm. All right. Y'all know I hate this damn place, but I had to make a quick run. Do you see me? Becky. So I'm going to Walmart, y'all, because I was getting some paperwork together for Jasmine and trying to scan it and stuff back to her, and my ink was not making it clear, so it's time to change my ink cartridge. So y'all know I gotta go to the neighborhood Walmart. So yeah, I hope I just come in here and stay focused, because I never can go on Walmart and stay focused. So let's pray I can do that today. Some pretty ferns . Wish me luck. 1 hour later, y'all. 1 hour later. Because I got stuck on the allergy medicine aisle trying to find Jada some allergy medicine, because allergies been kicking her butt. So mommy gotta be super mom and come to the rescue. So got her some stuff, picked up my long aid curl activating gel and Curl's Daughter black vanilla leave-in conditioner. I'm gonna try some of these things, y'all. I can't try everything now that y'all telling me, but I'm gonna try a thing at a time and see what I like and see what works best. Where is my freaking car? So I got that, and then I picked up some beauty aids, and I'll show y'all when I get home. Yeah, that line was long because I had to get the over-the-counter stuff. Stephanie don't buy sinus medicine no more. That's on the shelf. That ish don't work. So why even waste your $8 on something that you already know ain't gonna work? Get the over-the-counter brand. Sometimes you end up spending the same amount or more. But Jada needed something because she got sinus and she has like allergies. So she got a little mix of both, a little congestion. So mommy finna save her. Oh yeah, so let me get back to this house so I can take me a shower and carry on with the rest of the day. Yeah, thinking about doing a makeup tutorial for y'all today, and I gotta take pictures anyway from my website. So why not do two things at one time? A makeup tutorial, and I gotta take pictures. So yeah, so y'all, let me pay attention and drive. I made it back to the house, and y'all, let me just dash out this. I gotta come in close because she don't hear me, okay? But drama with the women starts young, super young. Y'all, Jada teacher just called me, right? And she was telling me that, you know, today Jada was basically complaining that her back was hurting and like she aching and shit. That's why I just had to buy that, you know, cold and sinus medicine, okay? Anywho, she said she wanted to call and tell me that. However, she also wanted to let me know that, you know, she understands that girls go through drama, they have hormonal changes, and you know, they be up and down one day. And she was just like, I think Jada is having some issues with some of her girlfriends. And she was like, you know, I don't know exactly what they are, which I know she lying. Y'all know she know. Okay. However, she was like, you know, with the dance coming up, the coffee house event, her parents, you know, she was like, you know, I just don't want her to not to be able to enjoy it because she got girl drama. Okay. So y'all know I asked Jada, right? Yeah. She told me, she was like, mommy, I said, well, are you having any issues with your friends? And she said, I said, just, that's up, shit, you know? I ain't your daddy.
And so she was like, well, a boy likes me and I like him, and her friend likes the same boy. The friend mad because the boy likes Jada and don't like her. And I was like, okay, so have y'all talked about it? And she said, no, I don't want to talk about it. I told her, I said, don't be like that. Address the situation. And you know what? You can just tell her, I ain't responsible for him liking me, damn it. But don't say damn it, but I ain't responsible for that. Dudes is gonna like who they like. And that's just the bad thing, that when you have girlfriends, it's like, and you're still in high school and shit. I already know, y'all, it's about to start, okay? He like her, but he don't like you, but he like me. I told her, tell your friend to get your life, because you don't control who likes you. You don't control who thinks you're attractive. You don't control it. And if you are going to end our friendship over a dude not liking you, was we really friends anyway? Y'all, I had this happen to me. And when I get out the shower, I'ma tell y'all what happened.
Hey, y'all, guess what I am cooking for dinner? That is what I'm about to cook. I got my drumsticks. Y'all see the seasonings, garlic salt, curry powder, lemon pepper chicken stock, my all faithful teriyaki sauce, some sliced up potatoes, some onions, and some carrots. And I'm about to hook it up. I'll show y'all what it's gonna look like right before I go and make y'all. This is everything. Chicken broth, teriyaki sauce, all potatoes is mixed on this side. Corn and carrots, and I'm about to put some water in here so it can steam. And there is Jada. Yeah, there's Jada. There's Rocky. Yeah, y'all see it? I'm looking back at him. He's looking back at him. Yeah. I don't know who you're talking to. He'll tell me you shut up.
Yeah, but you bow down to me.
Yeah, I'm not bow down to you. I'm stretching.
Yeah.
Stretching.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't
guess whose birthday's on Monday, Rocky?
Mine.
Your birthday's in December, so
shut up. Mine.
It's my birthday. What's your turning 15?
Whenever. No, I'm gonna be turning 10. I'm about to be 70 years old. I look damn good to be 70. Yeah.
It's gonna be fun.
Yeah.
Since I can't celebrate it during the week, because there's too much stuff in the week.
What you got going on next week, Jada?
Formal. Coffee house, my birthday, and then after formal, the day after formal, I'm supposed to be hanging out with a whole bunch of girls.
Key word, y'all. She said supposed to. Anywho.
And then this weekend, I'm supposed to be hanging out with my friends for my birthday. I gotta talk to Mr. Long first. I talked to her. She didn't answer. I gotta talk to him.
Y'all know how it is. Parents gotta come together, honey. Can't be no mutinies, okay? That's right. Then you gotta ask me.
No, I'm not asking you.
You're gonna ask me. I have the final say.
I'm not asking
me.
You.
If I smell them and they don't smell right, your ass ain't going.
You've
nowhere.
Already smelled them.
Oh,
before.
Shut up, Jada. My nose works sometimes, and sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't.
No.
Let me go over here where my mom is. Yeah, I'm over here. No mutinies. My mom. Yeah, my mom.
Bye, y'all. It's Peyton, and I'm gonna let you guys see, what was your name again? You're Paula, right? Yeah, that's Paula.
So, Paula, you better be back by 6:30. Do you hear me?
I said yes.
Okay.
Y'all, I am about to do a summer spring makeup tutorial, and Paula is about to go to the park. You gotta give these kids like a time limit to come back, because they'll just like act like they lost track of time. I mean, I'm not the one. It's time for Peyton to get cute.
Right, y'all. Mama Steph let me hold her glasses, and like, I think they look better on me than they do her. What y'all think?
Y'all saw Peyton. Peyton throws shade. But that's okay. It's okay. It's a
okay. All right, y'all. I was able to finish that makeup look that I was telling y'all about, and this obviously is the finished look. So, y'all, this is clearly the makeup look, and I'm keeping it 100 with y'all. You know, I wasn't changing clothes for this, okay? I am casually chilling at the crib, and later on, y'all will see how I will make a t-shirt and some shorts. Still be sexy, okay? It ain't hard. I'm gonna show y'all later. But anywho, I was talking to y'all earlier about Jada and her little young girl drama and how I experienced something like that, and I'm gonna tell y'all, it was the worst. And the worst in this way, okay? There was a guy, that pretty dude that y'all saw that I took that picture with, prom, senior year? No, it wasn't even prom. It was homecoming that year. That pretty dude that was with me in that white dress. Well, he liked me. I liked him. And y'all, my best friend at the time, throughout high school, we've been rolling and we've been homies since the seventh damn grade, okay? She liked him too. This is the kicker. I didn't know she liked him. I had no idea, no clue. And so I remember, if my memory serves me right.
Cause y'all, I try to do a brain dump on ish that don't mean ish to me no more. I try to do brain dumps and like, dump it and never ever try to retrieve it again. Do you feel me? So that's what I'm saying, if memory serves me correctly.
Y'all, we was at a basketball game, and I happened to tell her that me and him had started dating. Oh my God. Y'all, let's just say this. It is safe to say that me and my best friend were no longer. And y'all, when I say like, this is like a crucial time in a girl's life, you know, senior year, y'all got shit going on, you know, we was cheerleaders, the girl, we've been rolling together, y'all, since the seventh damn grade. Did I mention that? The seventh grade. And y'all know how dudes be like, bros before hoes. Shit, it should have been us before dogs, because y'all, first of all, I dated him for 4 months. Y'all know how relationships are in high school. Don't nothing last long. It ain't eternal, okay? Well, I guess it kind of is. I did marry my high school sweetheart, which was James. So, it just depends on the individual. But, I remember, I only dated him for 4 months. We dated from September to December of my senior year. And like I said, y'all, me and James started dating February of 92. And that was our senior year as well. So we stopped being friends. Like, no prom planning together, no grad night planning together. And in South Florida, y'all, everybody goes to Disney World for grad night. And unfortunately, my mama ended up pregnant with Ashley, and I had to choose prom or grad night. Clearly, y'all, I chose the prom, okay? My mom was a single parent. Let's just keep it real on that eat too. She couldn't afford to be doing extravaganzas for one, and then on top of that, the other. So, back to the topic at hand. Y'all, we just like missed out on everything together our senior year. And do you know how hard that is to be walking down the hall and you see your ex-BFF and y'all not talking no more? Like, we could be cordial, but like, we wasn't talking, like we wasn't homegirls no more. No more phone calls, no more nothing. And I'm gonna tell y'all, cause it was an ugly, ugly ending with a beautiful outcome later on in life. And y'all missed all of that. I remember on graduation day, we did pass each other in passing and we hugged each other and we wished each other the best with the rest of our life. And that was it, y'all. We ain't talk no more. Fast forward 2 years later, I remember it was New Year's Eve, and this was 94. New Year's 93, and then y'all know Jasmine was born January 25th, 94. We saw each other at night watch service at church, and I was clearly very, very much so pregnant with my baby daddy's baby, and she saw me, but she looked at me like she was disappointed, and like, I was like, wow, you know, I wasn't ready for that. And, you know, we waved and we, you know, we made eye contact and we kept it moving. However, that was like the last time I had talked to her or saw her from what I'm about to tell y'all now. 9 years went by. 9 long ass years, okay? And y'all, one day I got a phone call. Phone call was from my mama, and she told me that she had saw my girl. She saw her at somebody else's graduation, somebody else graduating in our family, and somebody was graduating in her family. And she ran into her, and she was like, you know, she asked about me, and she said, you know, she gave her my phone number and all of this. And y'all, let me just tell y'all this. She called me one night, and we were on the phone. I know. Do kids think they are smarter than their parents? I have mother radar and it goes off. How you supposed to be doing your homework and you doing research and your ass is upstairs downloading Kick, Messenger, and Facebook? Like, really? I'm mad. I don't get it. I don't get her and being sneaky. I just don't get it.
Y'all, I ain't gonna lie. God whispered in my ear and said, go check and see what Jada doing. Go check. I love the children I have. However, you couldn't pay me to do this again. I wish they could go from like, I like when they like from like babies up until like maybe like eight years old. And like we could just fast forward through puberty and teenage years and then come back to me like when you about 18, 19. I had to walk away. I was about to chop somebody in their damn throat. Like I was about to break a nail. Currently she is staying out of my path because I have the Mayrose syndrome and I'll reach out and touch your ass at any given time.
Sorry, y'all saw that little intermission. Y'all had to go handle some shit real quick. Anywho, what I was saying was, me and her talked like from like 9 o'clock p.m. to like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. And yeah, we mainly was catching up, but then for a brief moment, just brief. And when I say brief, y'all, we probably talk about him for like 15 minutes, if that, okay? But we had to bring it up because that was the elephant in the room. We brought it up, we talked about it, and we just realized how dumb that was. And she was just like, Steph, I just can't believe like I missed out on so many like milestone moments that have happened to you in your life. And she was like, you had a baby, and she was like, and I saw that. And she was like, and then you got married, and you know, y'all, when you growing up with your homegirls and y'all young like that, you dream of your girl, your friend. Y'all been rolling since the 7th grade. You dream of her being there with you to share that moment with you and to be your maid of honor. And y'all, it just was dumb. It was dumb. And I'ma just tell y'all, ever since then, we ain't been separated no more. She is my voice of reason friend. When I call her, when I'm all agitated and got my panties in a wad, she is the one that I will call because she will make me see ish clearly, crystal clear. And she does. She plays devil's advocate and, you know, she'll get me to think and stuff, but she always puts it in perspective and she's not afraid, y'all, to tell me yo ass wrong. And you know what? When she tell me I'm wrong, I can take that with a grain of salt just due to the fact that I know she's not gonna tell me nothing wrong. She's just not. And we had that one little hiccup in our friendship that lasted, you might as well say 10 years going to round it up. And we were able to rebound from it and we haven't had any issues thus far. Now, one of y'all asked me in the last vlog I posted, y'all had asked me, because y'all don't have Snapchat, how would you deal with a, I guess, like, sibling rivalry when it comes to your sisters and brothers and stuff? Well, I'm gonna tell y'all, do I think it exists? Yeah, it does. it does exist. And I think it exists when children clearly are all different, all right? And somehow it gets in some of the children's heads that they think mama is treating this one better, or daddy is showing more favoritism towards this one. And y'all,